Hello, this is Jake here from Apple Art Block, and today we're making robots out of cardboard. First thing you need to do is print off two templates off the website, the robot body template and the robot head template, and you're going to just cut that out. So you've got your two templates cut out for the head and the body, and then you want to find some cardboard around the house. I'm using a cereal box. Get your template, put it inside the cardboard box, and then just draw around it. Now I'm going to cut them out. Alright, now you've got your cardboard, make sure you bend it that way so this is facing the outside. It's a nice, clear cardboard. Grab your masking tape and just start folding up the corners. Do the same thing with your head. Remember to fold the paper this way so you have your cardboard clear. We're going to do four limbs, two arms and two legs. So what you do, grab a piece of newspaper, and you're going to literally fold it up like a tube, like that. So you've got your tube, now give it a twist, like that. So you've got a little bit of twist in it, not too much. Then get your masking tape, and this is where you're going to try and make it nice and solid. Just give, follow the twist that you just gave it, all the way around, and you should your first arm done. Right, need two of those. For the legs, I suggest using maybe two pieces of newspaper just to make it a bit thicker, because these are going to have to hold the robot up. So two pieces of paper this time, folding it over like that. Okay, grab your body. Put a little hole there where the arm should go, like that, not too big, just enough to fit the arm in. One there, one here. Okay, if it needs to be bigger, just use the scissors you got, just sort of like make it a little bit bigger like that. Okay, let's stick these arms in. Right, and they should sort of go like that. I'm just going to make massive long arms. There's one arm. Okay, you got your first two robot arms in. Okay, the legs are exactly the same. You're just going to go from the bottom, put a little bit of hole in there, make sure you don't push down too hard, spin the pencil. One. Make sure the pencil's sharp. Two. You want to make them a little bit bigger with the scissors. Don't worry if you make the hole too big, you can sellotape it afterwards. Now we're going to stick our legs in. It's good if it's tight, it doesn't really matter. That's one leg in. Make sure they're the same length. Two, perfect, right. Now get your sellotape and just tape up all your edges. This is where you need a little bit of finesse. You need to get your finger in there and try and get rid of those wrinkles. Do it again. So, stick up onto the leg, go right down, use your finger, get right into those little bits, make it flat. You probably want to put four on each to make it nice and secure. From your remaining card, you want to get your masking tape, put it over there, make sure you've got a little bit going this way and a little bit going this way. Circle on the inside. You're going to need two of these, so make sure you do it twice. And you kind of want a little tube coming up like that. A little tube coming down like that. Cut it out. So you should have something like this. This is for your foot. When you have your foot, you want to put that on the floor, get that part sitting down and fold that bit of cardboard up like that. And you want to do the same for the other side. That's your first foot. Now you just want to secure it with masking tape. Okay, I've secured my feet on, but remember, you've got cardboard and masking tape. This is just a rough idea. You can do it any way you like. If you've got other boxes, stick them on, build your own shapes. It's completely up to you. Okay, we're gonna make a little neck. We just probably don't need it that long, so maybe like that. Wrap it up. Remember to give it a little twist to make it toughen it up. Masking tape it in place. Get your pencil, make a little hole in the neck again, like that. And then you probably want to do one in the bottom of your head. So that should fit in there, and then perfect. Kind of just put the length of neck that you like. I'm going with that. There's your robot. Just show you one last thing with the hands, and that's it. So I'm gonna put little claws, so I'm gonna split down the middle, like that. So you should have two parts like that. Now you get your masking tape. I'm making little claws. So you just wrap around like that. Make sure you get masking tape on both sides. What else could you make there, Jake? You can make weapons, you can do swords, you can do a drill, you can do a fist, you can do whatever you like with the robot hands. I'm gonna make little claws like that, bend it, give a little shape, and I've got my robot hands. And you can put a little bend in the arm there if you want to. Okay, I'm just gonna put some eyeballs into my robot. Okay, that's done, turned round. Okay, now you just want to decorate it, do whatever you like, use the paints, the glitters, the felt tips. You can even make accessory bits from another one I've made, little ears, satellite dishes, a little light inside the head, whatever you like to do. We'd love to see your robots, so send them in. Until next time, goodbye.